Hey, thanks so much for joining me today. I'm Kara, and this is my channel, Power to the Flower, a Zone 9 gardening channel. And as you can see, you've joined me to plant up a raised flower bed, and that's right over here. I want to share with you what plants I'm planting and some details about them, as well as some bulbs that I'm going to plant and some details about that, and then give you kind of the overview at the end. My goal for this video is really that you can follow along with me over the season. It's January 2021. Here in Walnut Creek, California. We are Zone 9B, and what's going to happen to these plants through the seasons. I'm planting a lot of spring annuals, which I never usually do, and so we're going to see how those look, how those fit into the bed, because I also want to have some perennial and evergreen structure in there too. But those spring annuals are going to go and make room, so I have this idea that it's all going to work out, but this is why it's fun to have a YouTube channel and watch someone else make the mistakes, or maybe the wins. As you saw in the video thus far, I've laid the groundwork for the irrigation system. So I've laid all the half inch poly tubing, and from that I will attach emitters. I'm not sure which emitters I want to use yet, so I'm still thinking about that. I will also attach one end of that half inch poly tubing to a timer system, and which attaches to a faucet, and I'll share that with you when I do it. Join me at the end of this video and I'll show you what it's looking like today, which is about 10 to 14 days after planting. All right, let's get started. All right, our first plant is purple passion delphinium. This little teeny guy is gonna grow 6 feet tall and 4 feet wide. It's a perennial in zones 3 through 10 and does well in sun to part sun and blooms from summer to fall with these huge purple bloom spikes. I've never planted this plant before, but I can just imagine it next to that lemon tree. In this case, I'm going to measure out 4 feet and pop it at the 2 foot mark. I want it to fill in that space really nicely. Next, I have a Mediterranean native called Trachelium ceruleum, or Hamer Pandora. I think it's Hamer. It grows 3 feet high and wide. It's also known as a blue throatwort or a blue lace flower. It loves sun, but it can grow in part shade. It has these large 4-inch purple blooms that I am so excited about, and I am going to place it right here in front of the delphinium so that that black foliage can contrast. Next up, I have a beautiful Gilardia mesa peach. This is a yellow version, and mine are always covered with butterflies. This goes 1.5 feet tall by 2 feet wide, loves the sun, and is a perennial in zones 5 through 9. I'm going to have it right at the front of the bed so I can see all those happy little flowers staring at me. Next, I have an apricot mask flower. This is a great size at 3 feet high and 1.5 feet wide. It's gonna tuck in the bed really nicely. It's full sun. It does self-sow, but let's see if that actually happens. I'd be thrilled. And it is a perennial in zones 9 and 10. Okay, listen to this idea I had for this deciduous climbing vine, Clematis étoile violette. Sorry about the pronunciation. It has these huge purple star flowers that I can just imagine climbing and twining inside of the lemon tree. So it loves full sun, but we live in a hot climate. So let's see how this Clematis does in our area. Next, I have one of my favorite plants of all time. I grew it last year and loved it. Lavatera trimestra pink blush, 2 to 3 feet high and wide. It was one of those spring annuals that I was discussing that will be glorious until it is no more, which happened for us around the beginning of July. This plant did great in our sun. It did great in part sun. It handled the heat, no problem. I actually bought 4 of these to disperse towards the front of this bed. It bloomed last year for me in a container for almost the entire month of June and part of July, and it is supposed to self-sow. Again, I would be thrilled if it did, but I'm also doubtful that I'm going to reap such wonderful bounty. Here we have a Henderson's Checker Mallow, another new plant for me, 3 feet high and about 2 feet wide. It's a perennial in zones 5 through 10 with these hot pink bloom spikes that kind of remind me of salvia, but I think are going to be a fun new addition to the planting bed. I am so excited about this plant, Cherry Drumsticks, which is also a full sun lover, a perennial in zones 5 through 10, and it grows 18 inches tall and 15 inches wide. Again, a great one to tuck into any bed. It appears like an allium, but it's hot pink. I can't wait to see these huge globes. I bought 5 of these plants.
Finally, I purchased 6 different varieties of poppies to fill out the bed. These will grow between 1.5 feet to 4 to 5 feet tall, so I am going to anchor them in the center of the bed. They are full sun, they are annuals in all zones, they self-seed, and supposedly are deer tolerant.
So at this point, I'm thinking I have a very full bed, but I do know that these perennials are going to take a little while to get in and settle in, and their growth this year won't be as much as their growth next year. So I'm going to use all these annual fillers to really make this bed quite layered and full, and I'm excited about that. Next, I need to walk through my garden and find any container spillers that I can steal to put in this bed over the rock wall.
I found this amazing sedum called Dragon's Blood. It loves poor soil, full sun, it's mat forming, and it has this lovely red color in the fall and winter, which will look beautiful over those rocks. I also ended up with a number of calibrachoa of various colors, and I found a pincushion flower that I decided to plant on the far side of the lemon tree. The last project for the day was to transplant this lemon coral sedum and plant next to it a similar but different variety called Sedum Angelina to see and compare over the next months how these two plants do against each other in this spot. So the last thing to do is to plant. This took us into the next day, and we're going to get these plants in the ground. To each of these raised beds, I added some extra planting soil, and then I also added starter fertilizer to each of the plant holes as we went along. And lastly, I wanted to plant 100 Muscari and 180 Ranunculus in this bed. I planted the Muscari up towards the front, here we go, and the Ranunculus in the back of the bed. So if this works, it's going to be an amazing show. With reflection, I would have done this differently. I would have started in the back of the bed instead of ending in the back of the bed, and I would have cleared the soil in one go, added all of the bulbs, and then added the soil back on top. But we learn as we go, don't we? And ta-da, here's our final view on planting day.
So that brings us to today, January 26th, and the bed is done, and even some of those little bulbs are already popping up. And it's been, what, 2 weeks? So this is pretty exciting for me. The bed's looking great, and maybe you noticed in the video that there was a lot of just mud around the bed, and so we took some of the extra bricks and pavers that we had and just laid them in this area as a temporary solution until we decide what exactly we want to do here. We anticipate that it's going to be a big patio like this, but perhaps with slate or something else. But we want to get an idea of whether or not that is in fact something that we want to do. So we just thought it would be great to get rid of the mud and to try it out. And we added a new bed. So I'm excited about that. And you can see I already have all the plants ready to go to put in that bed. And especially I'm waiting for my new David Austin roses to arrive anytime. So they're supposed to be delivered in January or February. So I anticipate that to come, and that's going to be super fun. Thank you so much for joining me in this video today. I hope it was really helpful for you. If you are not following me, then go ahead and consider finding me on Facebook or Instagram, because that is where I give kind of my daily updates on how things are growing in my garden. So if you're interested in seeing the follow-up on this bed, there are definitely some things that I'm thinking about, namely how the bed does with the redwood tree drop that's coming. The pine cones and the pine needles are super annoying, but I'm hoping that with the increase in bulk of the plants, then perhaps just a quick blow might get those pine mess out of there. Let's see. So other things will be just following up with the heat as the heat comes. How do these plants do? The bulbs. Also, I'm interested to see what happens with the different kinds of sedum that I've planted, the Angelina and the lemon coral, and potentially kind of continuing one of those on the border of that bed. Also, of course, I'm planning on bringing in some new plants in that border on the bottom bit, and so that will be fun too. So anyways, lots to do in the future. Thank you so much for joining me. I'm Kara with Power to the Flower. I'll see you in the next one. Bye.